Now to the day's other news, and killer Derek Ernest Percy died in hospital early this morning, taking his grisly secrets to the grave. As 10 News revealed last week, he'd been riddled with cancer. Despite repeated efforts from police and a bedside coronial hearing, he revealed nothing about unsolved child murders. Emma O'Sullivan explains.
Derek Percy's death is bittersweet for Gary Stilwell.
The spectre of Derek Percy that's hung over this family for 45 years has now passed, and we can sort of get some peace from that.
Retired policeman Bernie Delaney put Percy behind bars for killing Yvonne Toohey, the Victorian 12-year-old kidnapped from a beach in 1969.
He fantasised about what he would do. He wrote about it. He wrote pages and pages fantasising about what he would do to small children.
Shane Spiller was aged 11 and with Yvonne when she was taken. He defended himself, waving a tomahawk at Percy. But emotionally, he never recovered and went missing 10 years ago.
He was caught red-handed in that the little boy Spiller made good observations. He told the uniformed police, who were quick to attend and quick to do what they should do.
Mr. Delaney also believes Percy murdered Sydney toddler Simon Brooke. Percy was also in Adelaide when the Beaumont children disappeared.
We thought we had an opportunity towards the end. Unfortunately, that opportunity seems to have slipped past.
The inquest into Linda Stilwell's disappearance will resume and hear from one last police witness. Gary is hopeful he and his six siblings will be able to gather in Melbourne when a finding is handed down.
Hopefully Linda's legacy will be that my family is whole again.
It will mark the end of a dark chapter in criminal history.